طيب، السلام عليكم. Today we'll introduce our course, Data Abstraction Object Oriented Programming. And the reason I spare one lecture, يعني أخصص محاضرة كاملة for this introduction, is that we all agree on the same principles. نتفق على نفس المبادئ. So this, what do you call this sheet? أيوه, the syllabus. So this is the syllabus. خلاص. The syllabus is like the contract, عقد الاتفاق between me and you. If you like it, كملوا معي. If you don't like it, you can drop the course. لسه احنا في الأسبوع الأول. ما فيهوش حاجة ظالمة, بس يعني نبقى متفقين من الأول. ان الطلبه بيتوقعوا حاجات اكتر من اللي بنقوله. That is why I'm recording this lecture, at least this one, and I will post on YouTube. لو قلت لي احنا ما اتفقناش على كده, اقول لكم في الدقيقه رقم كذا والثانيه رقم كذا قلنا كذا. خلاص. So first thing, data abstraction and object oriented programming is the name of the course. Course code is CS112. طبعا لسه ما بيكتبش. Just a second. بس I said syllabus, وهو يمثل يعني الكونتراكت كما لو كان يعني العقد. And then course code is CS112. Prerequisite is CS101, which most of you just finished. Usually there are two or three students who took CS101 long time ago. But for this, I'm going to quickly review at the beginning CS101, as we said last time, so that everyone knows what I need from CS101. You don't need everything from CS101. For example, I will not review the files. Not that files are not important or files are not related to object-oriented programming. لا, طبعا we can have object-oriented programming code that contains files, but we are not going to cover it in CS112. خلاص. What I need from 101 are the arrays, pointers, structures, and most importantly the functions. Why? Because classes contain functions. لا يعقل. That you, it is unbelievable that you don't know functions and write object-oriented programming code. Then this is the catalog description. We're going to cover classes, objects, methods, private and public members. Methods are functions. This is why I'm telling you, well, we must understand correctly what functions are to be able to take this course. And the basic things, the pointers, all structures are similar to classes, so it will be a good introduction for this course. I'm going to cover what we need from CS101 in the first 2 weeks, تقريباً. Then, to be sure that you understood this, I will have a quiz on the revision. خلاص, it will be early in the in this course. It is required by all the students that enroll in KCST, whether you are electronics department or CE department or CS department. But if you are ECE, this is the last CS course you will take. If you are CE student, then we are still at the middle. You still have 3 more programming courses after that: data structure, database, and software engineering. Even after this course, if you are a CE student, 4 credits. طبعا عارفين. For now, I'm the only instructor. Okay. So since we have only 3 sections, I will be the only instructor here. This is my office, but I have office hours. Soon, inshallah, during this week, I will post my schedule on the door. because some students think the doctor must be available 24 hours in the office. Even if they come at midnight, they should find him. No, it's not true. Even if I am in the office, sometimes I am busy and I cannot accept students. I will tell you, please come back during my office hours. If you really cannot come during those hours, maybe you can arrange other hours for special case students who cannot come during those hours. The TAs, Tariq Muhidat and Wael Khairi, most probably you have been taking 101-1, so I think you already know them and you know their offices. If you don't know their offices, also post them on Moodle. This syllabus is on Moodle. Moodle is working. So we are going to, we have no reason to delay. We are going to start our review of 101 starting from Thursday. Yani, I already promised you I will not take attendance in the first week, خلاص عندك المتي. But let's not delay. خلاص خلصنا الشوكولات first day, second day introduction to the course. Starting from first day, بس في ناس فاتها الشوكولات شوكولات أول يوم بس. Thursday, خلاص we are going to start our review of 101. Textbook. This is the official textbook required by the university for this course, and I will cover what I need from this textbook during the lectures, and you will have enough assignments and problems in the tutorials. So lecture problems and tutorial problems are both important, because I will mainly be focusing on code. But it is always useful for your information to have a reference at home. If you are going to continue programming, then you will need a reference marga for the C++. And this is a simple book by Herbert Shield. This is my favorite author. And also this textbook that is required by the university, by Tony Geddes, is simple and introduces the material, and is also a good reference for you if you need programming in the future, maybe in your final year project. This is all what I can say about the textbook. And as I said, today we are going to finish quickly. I just want to introduce the course and نتفق على الأمور ذات الاهتمام المشترك. طيب. The class web page on Moodle is the only official source of information. Don't tell me, I thought the lecture was cancelled, I thought there was no quiz, because some students sent on Telegram that you said there is no class or there is no quiz. The only official source of information is what I post myself on the Moodle. خلاص. If you are absent, if you miss a quiz, because you thought that there was no quiz, I put all the information on Moodle. If I forget to put information on Moodle, then I say it in class, in lecture. You are responsible for everything I announce in lecture, or announcement. Everything I announce in lecture and everything I post on Moodle. So sometimes, of course, Moodle is not working. This is for everybody. So you are not able to read Moodle. I'm not able to post on Moodle. In that case, this is why we announce on class. But this doesn't happen many times. Until now, I have not decided if I will post all the lectures like last year on YouTube channel. At least today's, not lecture, but this is just introduction to the course, because it contains the important information. So I'll post it on the YouTube channel. It is not official, and maybe I will not post everything on on the YouTube channel. Maybe I will not post anything on YouTube channel, because what happened last year, first year it was a success. YouTube channel was helping the students. For example, you attended the lecture, but maybe I was talking too quickly, maybe you did not sleep well last night, so you are sleeping in the lecture, so you missed some parts in the lecture. So usually the students check on the YouTube channel, on the video, and they fill up what is missing. And it was successful two semesters ago. Then last semester, the students thought that this was an online course. This is not an online course. This is an interactive course. I talk to you. I ask sometimes questions. You answer me back. Sometimes I give chocolate. Sometimes I give bonus points. But it is not an online course. So the attendance was very poor last semester. And they said, okay, I will look at the videos the last day before the final exam. Of course, the last day, you cannot watch 20 or 30 hours of video. So what happened? They were absent. They were not able to understand the lecture. In the video, you cannot ask the YouTube. He will not answer you. But in lecture, you can ask me if you have a question. So this resulted in very low, not very low, but yani, lower than average grades in these courses. This is why I was thinking that this semester maybe I will not put the lecture on YouTube, so that when you are here and I say something, you remember 50%, 60%, better than zero. If you are sitting in the cafeteria all the day, then you miss all the information I said. Bad grades does not mean that the average was low. No, but I had only one full mark in 120 students. Usually I have many full marks. I have many A's, but there were very few A's last semester. And I think maybe because they are looking at the lectures on the YouTube. هل لديكم تعليق؟
نتمنى دكتور
تخلي القناة. لما استفدنا من الـ C100؟ في السمستر ده كان فعلا حاجة ناجحة. يعني sometimes I say a comment, تعليق during the lecture, but the student didn't notice what I said during the lecture, but when the student watched the video after that, it was helpful for him. The student told me, يعني أشكرك يا أستاذ، أنت قلت الكلمة دي وأنا انتبهت أنك بتلمح لسؤال في الاختبار، ما انتبهتش ليها غير لما شفتها تاني مرة في اليوتيوب. بس التجربة التانية كانت فاشلة جدا، يعني السمستر الكورس اللي فات، يعني للأسف يعني الحضور كان ضعيف، يعني ثلاثة أربعة بيحضروا من 50 طالب.
بس
خدوا الجزاء، المفروض ان الدرجات نزلت. طيب بس انا مسؤول اني اعلمكم، يعني انا حطيت لكم حاجه خليتكم
خلوا القناه وعطنا تمرين.
خلاص
واكيد
اللي يبون فوق 25%
ترى تطبق
تنقص الدرجات اوريدي
كذي
ما
اللي يبونه. يعني لا تحاسب بتجيبوا في ناس يجي اخر السمستر and he has a pile كومه من الطبيات
لغوه كمان
الحين خلاص مستشفى لازم تطبيق.
طيب خلينا افكر في الموضوع. As I said, Moodle is the only official way of talking to you, discussing with you, but please do not send me too many emails. خلاص؟ Only if it is an urgent issue, أمر طارئ، وأنا لا أحدد يعني أمر طارئ ولا لا. يعني if you send me, for example, an email asking me, please add one grade to me so I can get B or B minus instead of C. This wastes my time reading your email. And what happened by the end of last semester, before the results, I get maybe 10 or 15 emails per day. يعني كان محتاج أكون متفرغ أو يعني هاير يعني عين سكرتير يعني يقرا الايميلات ويرد عليها. مش معقول يعني كده. ف يعني if يعني اعذروني يعني لو الايميل انا حسيت يعني انه مهم I will answer but if it is not an important email I will not answer the emails and بوجه عام limit the number of emails عدد الطلاب بيزيد when you have 100 students and every student think he's the only one who is sending the email but usually before the midterm before the final after the final and before the grades I get maybe 50 or 60 emails. I cannot read all this and it wastes the time. So use the Moodle messaging system. You can send a message with Moodle, but only if it is urgent and I will decide if it is urgent or not. طيب نيجي للكلام المهم الgrading policy. ما هي اللي how do you earn grades كيف يمكن الحصول على الدرجات in this in this course we'll have assignments in the tutorials خلاص will be worth 5% they should be submitted on time واضح for example, this week, no tutorial. Next week, first tutorial. The teaching assistant, المهندس, is going to discuss with you the problems. Then they are due to be submitted the following week. الأسبوع التالي. خلاص. If you are 1 week late, بعد الأسبوع ده, you get half the grade. More than 1 week late, zero credit. Why? Because the same thing happens. Some students come the day before the final exam with all the assignments, 10 assignments, and they give the TA, yalla dini darajat al-A, 5%. Well, this is not accepted. The TA has other things to do than grading all the assignments on the last day. The purpose of the assignments, الهدف من الassignment is that you progress gradually, التقدم في الكورس بطريقة تدريجية. That you progress gradually in the course so that we're going to take the lectures this week the week after will be the tutorials and labs and then after two or three lectures we get first quiz then similar thing lectures and the week after tutorials and assignments then we have a quiz so the purpose of the tutorials is that you progress in the course at gradual speed بطريقة منتظمة. As for the labs فيما يخص labs we'll have 5% grade for attendance only if you come in the lab you get 5% grade so instead of sending me an email please add me one grade If you attend the labs, you don't get only one grade, you get 5 grades. طيب, those 5% for attendance of the lab are different than the attendance that for which you get warning on the system. واضح? If you are recorded as absent, then you know what happens. And some students maybe failed the last semester because they were absent. But this 5%, this is from me or from the TA. Is giving you 5% to attend the lab. Why? Because some students, like they stay home and they make the submission from home on the Moodle, you will get only 5%. There is a grade for attending and working during the class. الهدف من اللاب is that you get a training during while you are attending during the lab. واضح? To use the PC yourself to be able to write code yourself and see if it is working or not. We still have 10%. This makes up the 25% of the in-course grade. The 10% for the quizzes, I will give the quizzes, I will grade them, and I will skip the lowest grade, which means if we are able to make 4 quizzes this semester as planned, then I will count the best 3 average, and if we don't have time and we do 3 quizzes, then I will count the 2 best. And then after that, yeah, usually after the midterm, many students are absent. And I will usually ask questions during the lectures, like what I did last lecture as an introduction. I will ask some questions, and those who participate with me, المشاركه, even if you answer incorrectly, you will get some bonus points. The bonus points count towards the 25%. So that, for example, if you skipped some labs or tutorial, or if you are not lucky enough, لم يخالفكم الحظ in the quizzes, and your grade is low, then I can help you with those bonus points. But I will not help you if you send me email and tell me I want one grade. ليه بأي حق خلاص. So this is the only way that you can get grades. وطبعا يعني للأسف أو لحسن الحظ 25% on the midterm and 50% on the final. For this cannot do anything. For the past two semesters I did not make a curve. برضه يعني تبغوا عاملين حسابكم خلاص. Well, what you get on the paper is what you get on the paper. You can ask your friends, did I change any grade? The only reason I may change a grade in the midterm or the final, if it is my mistake, I forgot to grade a question. I did not add the numbers correctly. If this happens, of course, you will get, because but if you just come because you want to be a student or B, what you solve here, what you put in the midterm and final is what you get. And this is the only way you can get grades. طريقة الوحيدة للحصول على درجات. There are other ways you cannot, by which you cannot get it. هناك طرق أخرى لا يمكن بواسطتها الحصول على الدرجات. أنا بنقولها لكم في الآخر. يعني من باب يعني الترفيه. طب الاتندنس بوليسي this is done by the university خلاص. And as you have seen, some students, for example, I tell you your grade is 23, but suddenly you find it is 20. Why? Because you are absent more than 25% of the lectures and labs and tutorials. خلاص. Let's quickly talk about the plan for this semester. It is already on the Moodle. So as I said last week, I'm waiting. I call this week number zero because I'm still waiting for the add and drop. But since we have Moodle, I think I already have most of the students here. It is already 29, so I think it is full. So we'll start on Thursday the review for us. We don't have to wait until next week. I will start the review and we'll have tutorials. لا ممكن اللاب يستنى شوية. I will tell you خلاص. You will find the information on the model if we have a lab or no lab خلاص. Next week. But we start the tutorial, which is very important to start practicing from the first week. Then I will continue the review. We need, it's very important for you to understand the functions and the variables. أنا مش هاخد غياب بس عايزين نتعرف بس بيك والأخ طلع بس ممكن نتعرف قول لي اسمك بس أحمد إيه؟
أحمد
الإيه؟ أحمد عباس صح؟ ماشي تفضل. It is very important to know the call by value, call by reference, return from function, passing parameter to a function. If the parameter is an array, it is different from a regular parameter. خلاص. Pointers array. I asked Dr. Sam and he said he covered all this in details. So we can go very quickly. I will talk about arrays of structures. مش متأكد he covered it ولا لا. طيب ممتاز. Dynamic allocation. Also he told me he covered it. So that we can have our quiz, because last time I forgot that we have on the third week, the fourth week, the national holidays. So I would like to have the quiz before that. Finish the review, have the quiz, and start talking also about the classes, objects, which is the topic of this course. Other? Then after that, we also have 3 more weeks. Alas, 3 weeks with more topics, C++, and we'll have the second quiz on the last week before the midterm. Maybe, for example, on beginning of last week, Sunday, مثلاً. So that we can cover everything in the tutorial. So we have 6 weeks before the midterms, because the first week we don't have tutorial, so it makes 5 submission, 5 tutorial, 5 labs. And we have another 6 weeks after the midterm. I will try my best to finish, يعني مش before Ramadan مستحيل, but in the first week of Ramadan we will have first week of Ramadan. I will finish the lectures, so you can have here the tutorials and labs. Then we have the review week. So I will try my best to that we finish in the first week of Ramadan. As you know, the lectures and labs become shorter, and with this plan, inshallah, we can have 4 quizzes. If we can follow this plan, then we have 4. Again, 6 weeks after the midterm, meaning 5 tutorials and 5 labs. So total, 10 tutorial submission, 10 lab submission. This is the only way you can get your grades. Not by sending email. If you send emails, I decided to do something. The emails الحاصلة على جائزة أحلى email. I will tell your the next course, next semester, the students about those emails. So if you send me emails, هنحتفظ بيها. ونوريها للاي ستودنتس اللي بعدها. فالايميلز التي حصلت على جائزه افضل ايميل الكورس اللي فات, ارجو منكم التفضل في مساعدتي في رفع درجه واحده فقط. This maybe I got 10 or 15 emails like this, درجه واحده, because it was B minus wants B, or B plus and wants A minus, or A minus wants A, or D plus wants C minus. توقعت درجتي افضل ولكن حرمتني الدرجة من فرحة التفوق. يعني الحقيقة الإيميل ده طبعا أصابني بالحزن. يعني if you send only one email, يعني أكيد بتأثر, بس when I get 10 or 15 emails أنا حزين, أنا مش عارف, أنا كده خلاص يعني التأثير بيقل. خلاص, أتمنى من أختك لو تساعدني بشيء بسيط, وطبعا علشان شكلي شيخ فيعني أختك في الله والكلام ده. الحاجة الثانية, النوع الثاني من الإيميلات هو الإيميل اللي يذكر فيه الأم, لأن طبعا ربنا وصانا بالبر الوالدين خصوصا الأم. وأنا مصدق يعني those were the true emails. أنا فعلا حصلت على الإيميلز دول. إيش رأيك دكتور, أنا حزينة جدا, وأنا أيضا حزين. ودموعي تنهمر بسبب ظروفي مع أمي. ويعني I got those emails, many emails from boys and girls that for example my mother is sick. طيب your mother is sick, يعني سوف أدعو لها بالشفاء إن شاء الله, بس مش هدي لك درجات. يعني الدرجات لن تشفي والدتك. طبعا نسأل الله لها طبعا الشفاء وكده, ونفس الكلام يعني فهذه هي الطرق التي لا يمكن بواسطتها الحصول على الدرجات. وبالعكس, I will keep your emails if you send me, and I will show them to the students next course. ولكن طبعا when I copy paste الورد طلع مش ملون. الحقيقة الورد كان لونه جميل, كان لونه أحمر, وكان ورق الشجر لونه أخضر, بس ما ظهرش هنا في ال when I make copy paste it is not clear. ولكن الدفاع خير وسيلة للهجوم. فthere is another, يعني أنا صنفت الإيميلات إيميل الهجوم. ممكن نفهم ليش اف يعني نحل ونتعب اف. فهو الحقيقه اول مره طبعا يعني انا تخضيت يعني، بس لما بيتكرر الايميل كذا مره فبيتحول. طيب sometimes students make a lot of effort. دي حاجه للاسف فيها يعني يمكن بعض الظلم، لكن الظلم ده في الدنيا يعني you make effort، ولكن في الاخر اللي بيحاسب على الافورت هو الله مش انا. الانسان بنحاسب بعض على النتيجه خلاص، فذا ريزلت يعني للاسف كان غير موفق. فحتى هومورك اسلمه، طب يعني لو ما سلمتش هومورك يعني كانت هتاخد درجه. عموما فهذه الطرق التي لا يمكن وصلت لها. في حاجه تانية جات لي بس للاسف ما لقيتش الايميل، كان بتقول انا دفعت 700 دينار في الكورس بتاعك. طيب هذا ال 700 دينار مش ليا انا. There is something you must understand. When you go to the market, you pay money to get product. Why do you pay money in a university? For registration of the course, the skill, the course, but not to get A or B or F. ال A وال B وال F بالنتيجة. خلاص واضح؟ طيب. نرجو أنكم تكونوا سعدتم بهذه ال، وإن شاء الله نبدأ يوم الخميس بقى جد خلاص. إحنا كسرنا الحاجز بين الأستاذ والطالب. And فين الريكوردينج؟ كنترول F.